We're going to give you the bad news first of all, and then we'll give you the good news. The bad news is this, that every man has sinned before God, and sin, the wages of sin is death, the Bible says. So God has made it possible for us. Those who have sinned, there is forgiveness of sins. When you become a Christian, you are a forgiven sinner. You're a forgiven sinner. The blood of Jesus was shed for you and for me and for all men so that our sins could be washed away at the confession of our sins. It doesn't mean when Jesus died, everybody can just do whatever they want. Those who are a slave to sin are a slave. Those who sin are a slave to sin. And there is no unrighteous man that will enter the kingdom of heaven. The only way you can do that is having your sins washed away. And that's why we're speaking of freedom today. The greatest freedom you can ever have is to have your sins washed away by the blood of Jesus Christ. There is peace, there is joy, there is hope. But if you want to continue walking in sin, that is your business. But sin will destroy you. Sin is selfishness. Sin is living without God. Sin is saying that I am my own man, I am my own person. You were actually made for God's glory. You weren't made to be selfish. You were made to be a man or a woman of love who worships God. God does not need your worship. God does not need your praise. But the Bible says he inhabits the praise and thanksgiving of his people. So when you give thanks to God for who you are, for what you are, for your families, for this life, for your five senses, for your heart that beats away 70 times per minute for 70 years, no maintenance. When you give thanks to God, he promises to fill you with himself, which is the Holy Spirit. Without the Holy Spirit, without being born again, you are not a child of God. You are outside the family of God. The first chapter of John says when Jesus came, some people accepted him. Some people rejected him, like many of you have rejected Jesus Christ. To the ones who accepted him, he gave them the right to become God's children, born not of a human, but born of God. And the only way you're going to get through death is through the blood of Jesus Christ. It's through humbling yourself, coming before him and asking for forgiveness for your sin. He will wash you clean. He will give you a new spirit. You will be born again. And Jesus said, unless a man is born again, you shall not even see the kingdom of God. You know, you people, you're walking in sin. There's sin in this street. You're walking in sin. Sin is selfishness. It is breaking God's law. It is sex before marriage. It is abortion, killing your children. That is sin. Sin is being a thief. Sin is being an adulterer. All sin is stupid. All sin takes away from life. God hates sin because sin destroys people's relationships. If you're selfish in your relationship, it won't last long. I'm sure each one of us know a selfish son or a daughter. We know a selfish wife. We know selfish teachers. We know selfish police officers even. We know selfish governments. Selfishness destroys everything. And all you people who walk past, you have sin in your lives. And without the washing of your sin, you are on your way to hell. And that's why we're here to warn you. You must, if you want life, you must come to Jesus Christ. Ask him for the forgiveness of your sins. The Bible says if you confess your sins, he is faithful and just to cleanse you of all sins.